The main question of this year's Biennale is how to live together. We decided to narrow it down to how will we live together with the machine, meaning our oftentimes ambiguous and difficult relationship with technologies.
Our journey began with quite a dystopian feeling that technology takes up too much space. Watching how our lovingly and cleanly designed honest architecture overgrows with layers upon layers of pipes, ducts, wires and boxes of different shapes and sizes.
Pilnīgi noteikti tehnoloģisks pārsātinājums ēkās arhitektūrā var būt apgrūtinājums. Sistēmas, lai arī cik viņas būtu attīstītas, viena ir nedaudz vairāk pagājusi uz priekšu, otra mazāk, un sistēmas savā starpā bieži vien nesaprotās tik labi, lai viņas varētu radīt to kvalitatīvāko pienesumu.
These days, architecture and the technologies we employ in architecture try to solve really big problems. The problems they solve are global and difficult to grasp. Oftentimes, it's hard to understand what these technologies are even trying to do. And when you don't understand what the technologies are doing, naturally you resist it.
Un tehnoloģijas jau risina globālus procesus par visas pasaules glābšanu, par tādām lietām, ko lietotājs parastais īsti neasociē ar sevi, ar savu ikdienu. Un tajā brīdī rodas nesaprašana un rodas dažādi pārpratumi.
And this resistance that we have found out working with our clients and speaking with other professionals is the main topic of our exposition.
So we expressed this initial feeling in our model. It was made of broken down appliances and technological trash we found around our office. Even our old coffee machine became a prominent part of it.
And the first model we made of the installation showcased our pessimism about the topic. And it was filled with real devices and engineering solutions.
We wanted to build a bunch of useless and overcomplicated machines, cluttering and whining and interfering with each other. We wanted to ridicule our enemy.
Spending some time thinking about, we slowly realized that technologies are just instruments for our own benefit, that people have created technologies for their own needs. This reflected in how we changed our initial installation.
Our initial dystopian perspective started to morph and evolve, and we wanted more to illuminate the usefulness of technology.
And we went for abstraction or symbolism. We put down the idea about employing real technical solutions and real pieces of technology, and we substituted it for this black pipe that symbolizes a wider range of technologies.
Mūsuprāt, tehnoloģijām nav jāseko akli. Tieši tāpēc mēs arī katrā objektā un arī ar šo te ekspozīciju un pētījumu mēģinām saprast to īsto balansu, kas tad ir tas tehnoloģija daudzums, kas ir pilnīgi noteikti cilvēkam vajadzīgs, lai viņš varētu arhitektūrā justies labāk.
I like this analogy that when technology is sufficiently advanced, you cannot tell it apart from magic. And that creates a paradoxical situation. We are in the 21st century and so such an advanced and complex society, but often we don't really know what goes on with technology. It is in a black box and you don't really know what's going on there.
It's sakarā ar to, ka pandēmijas dēļ Venecijas arhitektūras biennāle tika pārcelta par vienu gadu, mums radās iespēja Venecijas ekspozīciju realizēt mūsu dzimtajā pilsētā Rīgā apvērstā veidā.
Down on the Doma Square, really to see whether a communication will develop between the technology and the visitor. We didn't use the same installation, we used the same materials and we kind of inverted it using the same construction.
Apvērstā veidā, tāpēc, ka tajā brīdī ir iestājusies pandēmija, cilvēks ir atstāts viens pats savā mājoklī, un saikne ar apkārtējo pasauli ir iespējama tikai ar tehnoloģiju palīdzību. No šī mājokļa uz visām pusēm tika vērsti šie trubu gali, kas simbolizēja to pandēmijas sajūtu, ka cilvēks ir viens pats savā mājoklī, un ka viņš ar apkārtējo pasauli var kontaktēties tikai ar signālu palīdzību.
When thinking about this topic of how to live together with the machine, we have had a lot of differences in our team, in our office. But I think the value of our installation and of the book we have made is that we have brought different opinions together. And if they are polar opposites, when you put these little pieces together, you kind of see the big picture. I think that the project has gained a lot from us working together on it, sharing our experiences and having this result that came from teamwork. At No Rules, Just Architecture, we are a bunch of people with different views and different experiences, but we have been able to come together to try to see the bigger picture of how we live together with technologies. The exposition consists of two parts. One is the installation itself, and we have also made a book. It is made of pairs of texts. One text is a satirical short story, then a piece of engineering that is meant to help you and is meant to be useful in some way, does not really cooperate with what you want to do with it. And by using these short stories of techno-nonsense, we hope to speak to those who are techno-pessimistic. And the other text of the pair is an expert's commentary that just explains what exactly is going on in each of these situations. So we managed to have both of these polarized opinions put into one volume. And the installation also tries to mimic this ambiguous relationship people have with technology.
On the first view, our object is quite dark and menacing, but it was chosen deliberately as a contrast to the colorfulness of Venice.
Ekspozīcija arsenālā mēģina parādīt to duālo attieksmi pret tehnoloģijām un dzīves telpu. Melno cauruļu muģeklis simbolizē to tehnoloģiju arvien lielāko lomu mūsu mājokļos, kas aizņem arvien vairāk vietas, visas veidināšanas, rekuperācijas iekārtas, viņas ir milzīgas salīdzinot ar mājokli, un to mēs mēģinām arī parādīt šajā ekspozīcijā.
The main idea was to fill most of the available space in arsenale and leave free only a small room for people. The void in the installation represents a tiny archetypical shed house.
Tā nosacītā dzīves telpa, kas ir palikusi starp šīm caurulēm, tā ir tā dzīvojamā telpa, kas paliek cilvēkam, pārējo visu aizņem tehnoloģijas.
The first impression of the installation is slightly dreadful and off-putting, this huge mass of black pipes hovering over the empty space. But when you enter this empty space that is meant for the visitor, for the human being, you realize that the technology is actually responding to you and it's interacting with you. It's being friendly and useful.
There are 264 plastic pipes. By moving along these pipes, the sensor captures your movement and the lights slowly light up. The wooden floor is wired with tiny microphones, and the sound of your footsteps are amplified, given an effect of echo.
Skaņa čīkstoša koka dēļu grīda, cilvēks jau sajūtās kā mājoklī, atpazīst savus pazīstamos materiālus, un tajā brīdī mēs parādām arī to, ka viss šis draudīgais mudžeklis, kas no ārpuses izskatās draudīgs, viņš īstenībā ir domāts cilvēkam, viņš reaģē uz cilvēku, tas gaismiņas seko cilvēkam duāla attieksme, no ārpuses mēs it kā no tā visu baidamies, tā kad esam iekšā, mēs arvien vairāk iepazīstam tehnoloģiju un redzam, ka tā ir domāta mums.
And through this transformation, we hope to transform the way the visitors look at technology and the way the visitors think about technology.
Savā labākajā izpausmē arhitektūra ir domāta cilvēkiem, lai cilvēki varētu justies labāk, lai viņiem attīstītos viņu radošums, lai viņiem vienkārši būtu forši. Tehnoloģijas tieši tāpat savā būtībā ir domātas cilvēkiem, cilvēki rada tehnoloģijas priekš cilvēkiem.
It is a tool made by us, for us, and as any tool it must be used responsibly and wisely.
Tehnoloģiju attīstību nav iespējams apturēt un visdrīzāk to arī nevajag darīt. Tas, ko mums vajag darīt, mums vajag visiem kopīgi iemācīties sadzīvot ar tehnoloģiju, ar to mašīnu, kas pamazām jau pārtop arī mūsos. Tas mūsu uzdevums kā arhitektiem ir varbūt vieniem no pirmajiem saprast, kas ir tās sistēmas, kas tiešām palīdzēs cilvēkiem lietojot arhitektūru, reizē lietot arī to tehnoloģiju, kas būs implementēta mājā un tādā veidā justies labāk, dzīvot labāk.
The title of our installation, It's Not For You, It's For The Building, is of course a provocation. We try to empathize with the techno-pessimists and to talk with those who are skeptical about it. Many of us experience a lot of resistance when it comes to new technologies and change in general. And it's a natural process. The only way through is forward. And either we want it or not, we will learn how to live together with technology because that is the only future that we have. When you understand that technology is only a tool that we use, you realize that what seemed for the building is for you after all.